Hello and welcome to another pen video from me, Penultimate Dave. So we had our UK Fleet Fountain Pen Club meet up recently, and this was September 2018. And I thought I would just show you just a number of the pens that we actually had on show. As I said, we met up at Fleet, which is the Heron on the Lake, and it's a lovely pub that is right on the lake at Fleet, and it was a beautiful, stunning day. Lovely blue skies, as you can see there, and we had as always a really, really great time. So here's a picture of me standing outside. And so a number of the pens that we had on show here was a Omas Alba that Gary brought, and this was a very recent acquisition. I think it actually came the day before, so very recent. And but it is a lovely Omas pen. Reminds me very much of my Omas Ogiva cocktail that I also actually acquired from Gary a while ago. But this, instead of it being in a the one I have is a Blue Angel. This is more of a reddish version of the Alba, and it's actually quite nice. And then there was this other pen that Gary also acquired in the last month, and this is made by a custom pen maker in the UK, I believe a Dutch guy, and the company is called Powerful Signature, and this came in a medium nib and was inked up with Pelican Edelstein Aquamarine, and it actually is a really nice pen. Actually reminds me of the stripes that you would have on the World War II sort of fighter planes, things like the Spitfire and planes of that sort. There were a number of other pens that I brought along with me. I also brought along a lot of Visconti Opera Masters. I know these are pens that are very widely liked by a number of people in our pen club, so I decided to bring these along. And we have, from left to right, we have the Clear Demo, the Crimson Tide, the Proto, Blue Swirl Proto, the Golden Dust, the Luna, from Goulet, the River Thames from Chatterley, and then the Corvina and the Stardust, which are two new acquisitions for me, and they are exclusive to Truffaut, and I have a video review on those as well. I also took my Speakeasy as well, that is a mammoth of a pen, my Camelot, and then the Medici Il Magnifico, and then also I took my Wall Street there. And then a few more pens that I took along with me were some Armando Simone Club Bolognas. And from left to right, there's the Bologna Extra Wildside. And then I have four Arco Verdes, a gold and a silver trim, or gold and a rhodium trim, and then another gold and a rhodium trim. Two are inked, two are uninked. And then I have the Arco Brown. And then I have an Omas Milord Arco Brown and an Omas Paragon Arco Brown. And then I also had with me two new pens, which are the Right Here Now Scribo 2s. And these are made by Scrittoria Bolognese, or Scribo, in Italy, exclusively for Right Here. And this is the second edition of the pen. These came in a noble green and a cardinal red. I then also had a couple of Penidas, and these were the La Grande Bellezzas, the Gemstone Edition, and this was in the green Malachite and the red Rhodolite. And I have enabled a number of people, a number of friends, into buying pens within 2 to 3 days, or even 2 to 3 weeks, after attending one of my pen clubs that I attend. But this was a first. I actually managed to enable somebody there on the spot. I'm not going to name names, but she got on her mobile phone, went to the website, and ordered one there and then. Talk about master enabling. That was quite an achievement. I've never had that happen before. But she did like the broad nib that I had in the La Grande Bellezza. So it is a gorgeous riser, both the medium and the broad. I also took a few more pens along, again some Viscontis. I had some Homo Sapiens, and these were the Homo Sapiens Bronze Swirl, the London Fog, the Caput Mundi, the Jade, the Corsani 90, and the Corsani Octagonal. And then Anthony brought something very interesting, which I think I may have seen once before, but from a distance. He brought a mobile writing desk, and that for me was quite interesting, because I do like writing letters. I do like writing in lots of different places, and that actually made sense to me. It's like a wooden briefcase made for writing, made for fountain pens. Has a number of elastic straps in there where you can strap not only pens but pen cases in. You can also fit some notepads in there as well. So that actually was quite an interesting thing, and I might have to think about getting one of those at some point. And then there were a few other pens as well that I got to try from others. There was this Delta Fantasia that was on loan. And this is a gorgeous pen. And I believe this comes from John from pensharing.com. And it is a gorgeous pen. And I've seen this pen before from John. John wasn't at the pen club in Fleet this time. He normally comes to London, but the pen was brought along, so I had to have a look at that. And then there was this interesting journal cover or notebook cover, and this gorgeous design, the pattern imprint on it. And this is one that I've been looking at on, or a number of them that I've been looking at on Etsy for some time now. And I do like the way that these look. So again, that might be something that I might have to look at in the near future. I also managed to get to try a new Visconti Rembrandt Azure, and this, I don't normally go for Rembrandts. I have a merry-go-round, which technically is a Rembrandt. I have a couple of Van Goghs, but I don't normally go for Rembrandts, and this Azure is gorgeous and really is a lovely colour. And I, again, that might be another pen that I might have to seriously think about getting. I don't typically like the Visconti steel nibs that much. I prefer the gold, I prefer the palladium. I have a lot of steel nibs. I have Jovo steel nibs, and no problems with those. But I find that the Jovo steel nibs write better than the Visconti steel nibs. Just smoother. So for that, like, I'm not normally into getting Rembrandts or Van Goghs, but I might have to seriously think about this, because it is a really, really gorgeous pen. And here you'll see a photo, or a couple of photos of that Rembrandt Azure next to my two Van Goghs. I had a inkling that somebody might be bringing one, so I decided that I would bring my Van Gogh Pollard Willows and Starry Night inked up. And I think, as you can see, all three of those pens side by side are absolutely gorgeous. So it's definitely something I will need to think about. And then Jackie brought this lovely Thatcher Winter's Breath again, and this is a pen that is absolutely stunning. It's a Macchier pen with Raden abalone strips laid into the pen with quail's eggs crushed, and then I think it's 40 layers of lacquer, Yurushi lacquer, that gets put on top of that. And it is a beautiful, stunning pen. And it comes with a Sailor rebranded nib, a Thatcher nib. Jackie has this in a broad nib. And it is a gorgeous, gorgeous pen. So I just had to take another look at this pen because I'm pretty sure that this is almost sold out now. And it is a pen that I wanted, but... And FOMO, fear of missing out, is kicking in right now. But we have the London Pen Show coming up, so I need to seriously think about what could be at the pen show. And then decide afterwards if this is a pen still that speaks to me and I still have the money for it. But it is an absolute gorgeous, gorgeous pen. The only thing that does... sort of give me doubts about this is that I am usually used to number six size nibs or number eight size nibs, and this nib is more of a number 5 to 5.5, and so a little bit more like a Twisby 580 nib in terms of size. So that's the only downside on this pen. And then we had some lunch, and I decided I really didn't want much to eat, so I decided I would go for some fish and chips instead of a burger or something more heavier, like a steak or something. And then the waitress came out and asked which one of us had ordered the shark. As you can see, that's quite a shark, definitely. So, yeah, it's an amazing piece of fish, and it was very tasty, very, very tasty. And you can see a few group photos of us mingling there, talking about our pens whilst we were eating. I also took a few more photos with some of my pens out, and these were again my Armando Simone Club Bologna extras. And left to right is the wild side, the Arco Brown, and then I have four Arco Verdes, two in a gold trim and two in a rhodium trim. Gary also brought one of his Anotto pens, and also the two Conway Stewarts. So I thought that this would be an ideal opportunity. I've taken photos of mine together. I didn't bring mine with me though, so I decided that it would be a good photo opportunity to get the Arnotto and the Conway Stewarts together. So we have the Arnotto there in black, and then we have the Conway Stewart Churchill Red Stardust, and then we have a Conway Stewart Churchill there in the blue. And then you can see just the two Churchills on their own there as well. And Jackie had recently come back from the US and brought back a number of things. And one of them was this lovely bottle of ink. And it's only available in Japan and I think maybe one or maybe two fountain pen stores in the US. And I think it was around about $40 for the bottle of ink. It's a gorgeous bottle, and we joked about it looking like a hand grenade because it really does look like a hand grenade. I didn't actually try that ink. I didn't have a pen that I could dip with. There were also a few of my Visconti's there. These are the stacked celluloid pens. This is the Visconti Homo Sapiens, the Corsani 90, the Corsani Octagonal, and then the Wall Street. And then Jackie also brought along with her a lovely rocking blotter And this is one from it's made a handmade by a person in the UK that has since retired, and is sold by Bespoke British Pens. And I've seen this on their website a number of times when I've been ordering Conway Stewart's from them, and I keep thinking I do need to buy one, and I never get around to buying it. And after seeing and playing with it, and you can see me playing with it here, I was actually having a lot of fun actually just playing with it rather than actually using it as a blotter. So I did kind of get enabled there, and I did purchase one for myself when I got home. And then the beer of the day for me was Kronenbourg 1664. Unfortunately, two of the bitters that I was after was out. So third time lucky, managed to get a Kronenbourg 1664, and I've forgotten how nice these were. So I actually had two pints in the end, because you see there, I polished that one off quite nicely. Gary also got a Pineda La Grande Belitza. We actually did a group buy from our club in September. I bought the green malachite and the rhodolite, and Gary bought a green malachite. Now, he got his in a fine nib, I got my malachite in a medium nib, and I got the rhodolite in a broad nib. So we actually had a fine, medium, and broad there. So I thought it would be an ideal photo opportunity to take a photo of those three Pineders together. So that was really our Fleet Pen Club for September 2018. We had a great time. We spent a good 3 hours there chatting away to each other, testing each other's pens, talking about new pen acquisitions, new pens on our wish list, and a lot of pen news that's going around. And thoroughly enjoyed ourselves, as always. And hopefully some of these photos here in this video has gone some way to actually show you how much fun we had. So thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next pen video. Bye-bye.